Good afternoon, everyone. If you have your attention, we'll go ahead and get our event started.
Got in the microphone.
I think we're ready. Y'all hear me? Can you hear me in the back? Can't hear. Well, good afternoon, everyone. My name's Brian Haygood. I have the privilege to serve as Alamance County Manager. And I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome all of you to our fourth Citizen Volunteer of the Year event for Alamance County. And I just can't tell you how pleased we are to have all of you here. We appreciate you taking your time out of your day to be with us and let us, from Alamance County government's perspective, tell you all thank you and how much your work means to us. We have folks here from boards and committees that do work all across Alamance County through all different kind of county departments, and we appreciate what you do very much. And we started this event 4 years ago because we felt like it was a good opportunity to get the groups together. Maybe if you don't work with each other very often, you get to see that there are a lot of citizens who give their time to help make Alamance County government better able to serve our citizens. And I think, you know, we're blessed today to have a couple of county commissioners here with us. We're grateful for their attendance, and you'll be hearing from them in just a moment. And I'm sure they would agree with me when I say that it's not possible for the Board of Commissioners or for the County Manager's Office to do all the work that needs to be done across Alamance County. And the boards and the committees that you serve on really help make sure that our policies and the work that we do is relevant to our citizens, and we appreciate that. So welcome. We're glad that you're here. We're going to have some dialogue and some talks and eat some delicious food. And I want to take one moment to thank Tori Frank. I think Tori will probably get some other thanks throughout the course of this event, but I work closely with Tori, and I can't tell you, this is really an event that she spearheads and helps put together, and we appreciate it. And I'm sure most of you work with Tori in some fashion or another when you're getting folks appointed to your committees or you've got questions, and you'll agree with me that she's a great resource. So we're glad to have her and glad to have you all here. And at this time, I'd like to turn the microphone over to Ms. Jasmine Kirkpatrick, and she is the Membership Development Coordinator with Local Government Federal Credit Union, and they help us with this event, and we're very pleased to have her and her colleagues here too. So Jasmine, please come on up.
Well, good afternoon, everyone. I work for Local Government Federal Credit Union. Is volunteers on boards and committees on the Alamance County. You're eligible to join Local Government Federal Credit Union. We are the sister credit union, State Employees Credit Union. I would like to thank you all for what you do for your county and your community, and we are glad that we could be here today.
Thank you.
I think I know about everybody here. I'm Amy Gailey. I'm chair of the County Board of Commissioners, and it's my honor to be able to introduce to you today Ms. Garnetta Pickett. She wouldn't mind coming up. Our winner for the Volunteer of the Year Award last year was a wonderful gentleman, Mr. Earl Pickett, who I had the privilege of serving with on the board for the Department of Social Services. And he passed away back in June, I believe.
Yes.
And it was a tremendous loss to our whole community. Earl, he would text me sometimes, and he would talk to me. And we didn't agree on everything that, you know, in politics, but he was always so kind in his approach and always so open to discussing with me. He would challenge me, but was never disagreeable at all. And that made it possible for me to listen to him, you know? And I did listen to him. And he actually gave me some important things to think about. And I have personally missed him tremendously. When we had to go back to the DSS board meeting after he had passed away, it was actually physically hard for me to go there because I missed him, I missed his presence. He was a big man, tall, big, just kind, just wonderful.
Yeah.
Just a wonderful man. And he would text me, and he's like, he texted me back in March, "Good afternoon, my favorite county commissioner." And he said nice things, you know, just nice stuff. He was just a nice man. and I miss him tremendously, and his loss is a loss to the whole community. And we're just so glad, and he called her Sparkle. That's what I'm saying for you. So we're so pleased that Ms. Sparkle could be here today to represent Earl and to help us to tell her how much we loved him and how much we miss him. And that our prayers are with you for this holiday season.
Thank you.
Because he was really, he was a treasure.
Yeah. Thank you. Just a little. First of all, I say good afternoon and thank you very much, Amy, for those kind words. My husband Earl was indeed, he stood here on the 21st of June last year to receive the Citizens Volunteer of the Year Award. And it was on June 12th of this year that he passed to be with the Lord, with his eternal home. So I just want to thank all of you for your support for me and your encouragements as I go through this journey. It's not easy, but as long as I stand and I've got good friends and good family, it's much easier for me to deal with it. And of course, I'm leaning on the Lord because he's the one that's going to get me through it all. So I say to you that it's through Earl that I was able to meet you all and know most of you as friends of Earl. And he was a kind person, a kind husband, and he didn't meet any strangers. I mean, and if whatever came up, sometimes it came out. Thank you very much.
Commissioner
Carter is going to give a blessing over our lunch, and then we'll go.
Thank you, Amy. Amy touched on a couple of thoughts I've been having as well. We represent everybody in the county. It doesn't make any difference what party I'm from. Everybody in the county is a constituent. And I think the board we have right now looks at things that way. I know Amy and I do. And we want to come up with solutions for the citizens in the county. And it takes input from committees and boards such as y'all's. And that's what we need to try and find solutions. If we, you know, we don't know what all the problems are. I found a lot I didn't want to find out in the last year. But we have to try and find solutions, and it takes input from all the citizens of Alamance County to try and come up with the right answer to the right problem at the right time. So we appreciate your input so much. You have no idea. Join me in prayer, please. Father God, as we join here in your presence, dear Lord, we just recognize the peace that only you can bring. Peace to our community. Peace to our state, peace to our nation, peace to our world, dear Lord. We just love the presence and power that you bring to us. And we seek your guidance in the activities of the day, your activities in this group. And we ask you, dear Father, to bless the food that we're about to eat, bless it to the nourishment of our bodies, bless those who have prepared it for us. We ask these things, dear Lord, in the powerful and holy name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
So we're going to go ahead and get started with the presentation. So first we want to recognize the nominees, and then we're going to announce the winner of the 2019 Citizen Volunteer of the Year. And should I read out the nominees, all the nominees, and then go through and get certificates? How do you do that, Lord? I like to ask Tori questions when she's had a cupcake. Okay, so I'm going to just start with the folks, and first I want to recognize those who were nominated, and then we'll get the award winner. So our first nominee was Lawrence Abbott. Mr. Abbott, if you could come up, and I will read the citation for him. So Mr. Abbott has represented the Historic Properties Commission since 2015. He has taken his own time outside of commission meetings to develop the newly approved Alamance County Archaeological Survey. This commission represents many of the municipal jurisdictions in the county as well as the unincorporated areas. Mr. Abbott dedicated himself to doing the research of all properties that have the potential to be recognized by the HPC. Mr. Abbott has dedicated himself to provide a list of hundreds of properties throughout the county and hopes that those properties will someday be recognized at the county and state level as historic and preserved for that purpose. He has put in more work than any board member could be asked to do. He decided on his own that this project needed to be done and that he needed to take that on and never asked anyone else to help or dedicate their time. He truly shows what a dedicated person can do and help their board. He exemplifies dedication and selflessness to help his county. The next nominee was Kelly May. Is she here? I didn't think I saw her. So let me just read her citation. Kelly May has been a dedicated member of the Recreation and Parks Commission for many years. She is passionate about sharing the natural world with the citizens of Alamance County and providing quality programs and healthy activities. In addition to her work with Alamance Parks, she also volunteers with the Burlington Downtown Corporation, Ralph Scott Life Services, and the New Leaf Society. She serves in the Church of St. Mark's Church and is involved with many nonprofit organizations. She has had a tremendous impact in making Alamance County a better place to live. So we appreciate her. Our next nominee was Paul Walker. Come on up here, Paul. So Paul Walker has served on the Farmland Preservation Board for many years. Before his retirement from the North Carolina Cooperative Extension as the county livestock agent, he and others helped form the Voluntary Agricultural District in the early 2000s to help address the problems our farmers were facing with such rapid development. His concern for the loss of farmland has driven him to continue to serve as the volunteer and chairman of the Farmland Preservation Board. In his commitment to saving farmland, Paul worked part-time for the North Carolina Agriculture Development and Farmland Preservation Program, assessing farms for the state's program. With his diverse background, Paul is able to draw from his experiences and help lead the Preservation Board to protect farmland in Alamance County. Okay. So our next nominee is Courtney Doy. Is she here?
She's not here today. Okay. She wasn't able to attend.
All right. Is there somebody from the library who wants to take her certificate for her?
Absolutely.
And I'll read her citation. Courtney Doy has previously served on the library steering committees and is currently the chair of the library committee. She is a devoted library patron and works hard in her advocacy for the library, twice speaking before the Board of Commissioners during budget planning season. She is knowledgeable about projects impacting Alamance County through her role as the chair of the library committee, as well as her work as an English professor at Alamance Community College. So we very much appreciate her.
Thank you.
All right, so we have an exciting development this year. We had two winners.
Oh, wow.
We had two winners of the Citizen Volunteer Year of the Award. You have five commissioners, and we couldn't agree. But there's a good reason for that. All of our nominees are extraordinary people, but these two co-winners, people being recognized, are truly extraordinary. Each of them contributes so much to the county in so many different ways. And so it's my honor to give this award to Lee Isley and to Edna Parker. I'll start citation. Lee Isley has been an asset for the county. He is serving in his second term on the planning board. Lee has been instrumental in the rewrite of the heavy industrial development ordinance for the county, and that's an understatement to say. Lee has taken a leadership role while never being asked. He repeatedly considered all parties on the subcommittee and led the group even when it seemed the group was going in a different direction than what he would like, and that is true leadership. Lee is an exceptional person and as a volunteer has represented the planning board and the county in a professional manner. Lee is a great example to the best Alamance County has with his dedication to his board and the development of the county. He exemplifies what we all look for in any board member. Amen to that. All right, and Miss Edna Parker, come over here. Ms. Edna Parker is a dedicated member of Alamance County Social Services Board, serving her first term in 1992. She has been appointed through North Carolina Social Services Commission, Alamance County Social Services Board appointee, and currently serving as a 2019 appointee by the Alamance County Board of Commissioners. Ms. Parker is a highly esteemed member of the DSS Board. She has served as chair of the North Carolina Social Services Commission, and has served as both chair and vice chair of Social Services Board during her tenure. Mrs. Parker upholds the mission of social services by advocating for the well-being of the citizens of Alamance County. With her attention to detail, that's truth, and her leadership skills, also truth. Mrs. Parker has led the Social Services Board with passion and commitment while working to enhance the lives of Alamance County citizens and assisting them along the journey of becoming self-sufficient. Her advocacy for the elderly population has been evident over the years as a member of the Social Services Board to protect the lives of the vulnerable. Mrs. Parker also serves as a board member for the Women's Resource Center and Alamance Arts. She is an active member of the Alamance County Area Chamber of Commerce Women's Symposium. Her roles on these committees, as well as continued membership as a Social Services Board member, displays her efforts and commitment to the citizens of Alamance County. Her work has been a vital effort in improving the health, safety, and welfare of the citizens in this great county.
It's truly an amazing group of volunteers, isn't it? Let's give them another round. And the reality of it is there's so many more like them that dedicate themselves to the needs of our citizens. Let's move forward here. Let's see. We'll start out with the Adult Care Home Community Advisory Committee, Kim Johnson, and anybody else from that group, Piedmont Triad Regional Council. Are they here? I know you're pointing to somebody.
Foxy.
Foxy, yeah, okay. I don't have your name out here, Foxy, but stand up. I serve on that committee as well, and non-voting member, but I enjoy attending the meetings and keeping up with what's going on that committee. It's good. Thank you for your service. Nursing Home Community Advisory Committee, Kim Johnson and Foxy. And Planning Committee for Services for the Elderly, Teresa Jackson. And Foxy, right? Yep. Okay. Library Committee, Susanna Goldman and Terry Lamb and Dana Cunningham, and I saw, and Susanna, is she here this morning?
She is not. She's at a public library director's meeting.
And Paula Hendrick. So we all stand. Recreation and Parks, Brian Baker. Anybody else here from that one? Board of Equalization and Review, Jeremy Aiken. And is anybody else here with you, Jeremy? Don't stand. Alamance County Planning Board, Tanya Cottle. Saw Tanya come in there. And anybody else on the planning board? And Tanya, you can stay standing up. Historic Properties Commission. Anybody else here with you on that one? Social Services Board, Adrian Day and Carmen Morrow. Anybody else here on that one? Voluntary Agricultural District Board, Brad Moore, Gail Horner. Local Emergency Planning Committee. I don't have your name, sir.
Anthony Pierce.
Anthony Pierce. Okay. Justice Advisory Council. Anybody hear from that one? Your name, sir?
Art Springer.
I'm sorry?
Art Springer.
Art. Okay. Juvenile Crime Prevention Council. Tourism Development Authority, Grace Vanderweiser.
Patel.
Workforce Development Board.
Just me.
And of course, a special thanks to our local government, Federal Credit Union, for their sponsorship of this event. And we have a 2019 Fall County Government Academy graduates. If any of you are here today, would you please stand? Okay. Again, I think you have some closing remarks, Amy.
Yep. Thank you, Steve.
You're welcome.
So I just want to acknowledge the hard work and sacrifice that all of our county volunteers put into their community, and just express how much it means to me. Sometimes people ask me why I ran for public office, and what part of the answer is that I reflect on the sacrifices of those who go overseas, who put themselves physically in harm's way in the battlefield so that we can have freedom and security at home. Well, if they're going to do that, then the least that I can do is, you know, run for office or engage and practice those freedoms. And I salute you all for doing the same, because I think that implicitly you invest in your community out of a recognition not only for the sacrifices of those who paid the price for our freedom, but also you understand that our freedom, the nature of it itself, depends on us connecting with one another as a community. Our freedom isn't something that we just engage in. We're just going to read what we want. We're going to say what we want. We're going to worship in religion the way that we want. Our freedom depends on the relationships that we establish with one another in the community. That's really the bedrock of America. And I just thank you for being willing to engage with that. There was a philosopher, Alexis de Tocqueville, was from France in the early 1800s, and he traveled the brand new United States and remarked on what was different. He observed something different in America than when he was used to in old France. And he said, and I screenshot it, and now I pull it up. He said, the health of a democratic society may be measured by the quality of functions performed by private citizens. And that is truly, our nation depends on you all, and on me, and on each of us, and on teaching it to our children. You know, so thank you so much for coming out to this luncheon today, but more importantly, thank you for what you do every day in supporting your community. And even if, you know, your name's not going to be in a history book or something like that, that doesn't mean that what you've done hasn't been important and has definitely been recognized and valued by the people who have been working in the trenches alongside you. So thank you so much for being here today, and I hope everybody has a great Christmas and a great holiday season. So thank you.